If you've watched my other video about shrinking this cabinet size down, then you're already familiar with what I've done here, where I cut this, what was a 3 cabinet, down to a 2 cabinet. My reason for doing that is to add a TV to that area to make this more of a backside entertainment area. If you haven't done that and you have the stock 3 cabinet, then where this switch is actually a hole that's already going through that you can use. It's already pre-drilled in there if you just remove this bottom piece. And again, to learn how to remove this bottom piece, just watch my other video where I talk about cutting the cabinets down. I give a pretty detailed instruction on that. But in this particular case, I added this right here to be a reinforcement 2x4 to attach my speakers to. And then I drilled a hole through it. And I wanted to keep the light that was still underneath here. So I ran the light wires through, which is this strand right here. And then I've run my speaker wire also through the same tunnel there. And I don't think that the small amount of 12 volt is really gonna create any noticeable interference. If I end up being wrong and I have to shield one of these, then I'll post it and post an update to it. But I don't think that'll be the case based on experience with other systems. This isn't like it's a really powerful speaker system or anything like that, but definitely an upgrade from what's there. So that's the way that I have done the wiring to get it through to the speakers. And then I will put this trim piece back on to make it pretty. I'll update that here in a little bit, but now we'll step inside and I can show you how I'm gonna drop this wiring down to get it up to the front basement area where I'm gonna have my amp at. Inside in the back bedroom area, you can see where I've pulled out the top drawer and the bottom drawer of the 3 dresser drawers that are on here. And if you're not familiar with how to do that, it's pretty simple. When you pull the drawer out as pretty much as far as it'll go, you'll start to see a little tab stick its little finger out there, and you just push that up while you pull out on it. And on the other side, it's a push it down. But either way, you just push it in the direction that it's not in, and it allows you to pull the drawer all the way out. And the advantage to that is then you can see back behind here, this being the original hole where the wiring went through for the lighting, and then the additional hole that I've added right here to run the speaker wire through. And then you might be saying, well, how are you going to get up to the basement? And this is where you might be really surprised to learn that actually your basement is already kind of open to the back bedroom. That bright spot up there in the top left is the outside light. That's actually the slide-out stove in the outside kitchen, and I have not removed a panel here or anything. It is open like this. So definitely, if you are camping, I would not leave your outside kitchen large door open overnight, because you are, you know, of course, this drawer butts up against here, but it doesn't actually create a barrier. So what you see right there is the outside sink and the hot and cold water lines that run to it. And what I'm going to do is just simply drop the speaker wire bundle into the hole that's cut right there, and then we'll go back outside, and I've removed 2 screws from the chloroplast, and it'll be quite easy to fish my wire bundle through there and up to the front basement. This is where I've removed the 1 chloroplast screw here, and then it's pretty easy just to take a peek up in there, and you can see there's right where I've dropped that speaker wire down, right in the same hole that the hot and cold water are running through. I'm gonna pull this wire out, and then I'm actually gonna put it into a COT tube that I'll show in a minute, along with an RCA cable that I'm gonna run to run audio up to the amp to connect the TV to the amp setup. So here's where it can start to get a little confusing, but you can see this one right here is my corrugated outer tubing with the RCA cable and the speaker wire in it that I've been running. And all I've done is basically remove these little screws right here that attach this chloroplast underneath here. And you can see up in there, you know, there's all kinds of wiring and everything like that, but very easy to snake it all the way along. And then my preference, of course, is no drill solutions. So coming into the basement, your little piece right here is just held on by 3 simple Phillips screws, and you can easily pull that back. And then you can see into here, where I have pulled it up through the flooring right there, into this tubing right here. Now I did bundle it up a lot like this to make sure that I didn't have to cut off that excess speaker wire. So now I'll unstrap this and show you how I'm gonna mount the amp. Here's the way I did the front set of speakers. So this is the front basement compartment. You can see where I've mounted one on the left and one on the right. And again, I did the two in the back over in the back kitchen too, so that kind of no matter where, what the campsite looks like, I can get good volume across the entire thing. And if I want to power only the front or only the rear, you know, I can unplug the wire and do that.
These speakers are Klipsch's. They're just an outdoor rated speaker that was had a pretty good price at Costco. In general, I find Klipsch's to be a good dollar per sound quality value brand. Usually don't require a ton of power to make them sound good also.
This is how I'm driving the whole thing. I've used different small amps off of Amazon in several different projects. This is my third one. Each one's a different brand. One's a Fosse, one's this, and I can't remember what the other one is. But so far, none have ever failed me, and all of them sound good. And I've been using them in some cases for 4 years or so. For this particular setup, I went with this one because it has built-in Bluetooth. That's what this antenna is. And then it also is a four channel, meaning that it can power four speakers. It has an RCA input so that I can hook the TV up to this and power it. And then it also, what's a bit unique is that it has an FM antenna wire here where I had that tucked in earlier and it's fallen down. I'll retuck that in afterwards, but, it's kind of nice to be able to get in here and, even listen to the radio. It has a little remote too. You can kind of set a master volume up high. It has independent bass and treble controls, but once you kind of set, you know, as high as you want your volume to go, you can use this remote to knock it down some. I purposely mounted it right up against where this basement flap comes through so that I could just easily sneak the speaker wire and the RCAs. And then the actual power brick for this thing, I've tucked and hidden back behind here too, so that's completely out of the way, not floating around, not going to get caught up on anything. I'll do an audio demonstration. I mean, not that you're going to really hear it through an iPhone microphone or anything like that, but I will show what it sounds like with the TV hooked up here in just a minute. But anyway, yeah, these I've had pretty good luck out of these. This particular one, even you can put a bunch of MP3s on a USB or micro SD card and power it. And honestly, 45 watts RMS. I think that's technically on a 4-ohm speaker. These are 8-ohm. Most speakers you buy are 8-ohm, so it's probably not even quite 45 watts. But I've had this thing up to halfway up, and it's louder than I would ever want to be at that level to a neighbor in a campground. I mean, if I was completely by myself, maybe I'd listen at that level, but plenty of power for the efficiency of these speakers. Sounds great. And honestly, a really easy setup, and I've just put it in with some simple screws right here. It ain't going anywhere. It's solid state. These things really don't get hot. It kind of looks like it's got these heat dissipating fins, but I think that this unit will get hotter when this thing is just sitting in the sun and is closed off than when electricity is actually running through it. So here's the final product. I'm going to do a little sound demonstration, of course, depending on if you're listening on a laptop or listening with decent headphones. You'll be really be able to hear the difference between the factory speakers. And now I'm only going to use the ones on this side. Of course, I have them on the back side too, where I did the other video on the TV upgrade. But just to kind of keep it apples to apples, exact same standing position between the factory ones and then the upgrade that I've done here. So here are the factory ones, and I'll play like the same song so you can kind of just hear the difference. And that's cranked up fairly loud actually, and very limited in terms of frequency response. I don't know what the exact specs are on those little speakers up there, but I can't imagine that they can handle anything much below 150 hertz, if that, honestly. And honestly, they just sound very tinny to me. So now I'll get the Bluetooth switched over and do the same thing for the new setup. So here we are, same rough distance, and now we'll use the second set of speakers here. So if you're listening on any sort of speaker at all, you should be able to hear that there's actually the bass line picks up and the overall sound quality is a whole lot better. So again, I don't expect that the average person watching this is going to put a set up here and a set in the back of the camper. I realize that that's probably a bit more obsessive than the average person would do, but it definitely will give me full coverage for listening to whatever I want to listen to at a site, a lot better control, a lot better sound. And again, you know, really simple to run one of these. This particular one, you know, had radio line input, so I still have the TV line running into there. So if you watch my other video about how to set up the back TV, that all runs into here. Easy to everybody watch the movie, hear what's going on, that sort of thing. One key point on these is I did spring for the shielded RCAs, and you know, when I flip over to that line input, there's definitely no hum or anything like that. But if you're going to run 35 feet of RCA cable from the back of the camper up to the front, you might want to think about running shielding on there, just because it will be up against several other wires. So that's it for this one. Leave me some feedback, let me know what you think. But again, I think that depending on what your needs are, a very easy upgrade if you just want to do the two up here in the front basement, or if you just want to do the two in the back. But with these really simple amps you can buy off of Amazon, you can really upgrade the sound quality for not a lot of money in your camper. And it's a whole lot simpler than trying to cut out the existing speakers that are kind of built into the side of the camper. So leave me some comments, let me know what you think. Thanks for watching.